Exclamation, everybody, and welcome to Heroes of Andromeda. So, this is just a demo, free demo game that you could download from itch.io. And there's not a whole lot of information about it. So, and I don't know, it's not, the project hasn't been very active. I think the last update and stuff was like 300 days ago. And when you look at the Steam concepts page for it, that also hasn't been updated since 2015. So I don't know if the development is continuing on it or not, but I stumbled onto this entirely by accident. I was responding to an email from a developer who said, go download my game and take a look at it. And as I was downloading that from itch.io, this was recommended, one of the recommended games that I might like while at, on the download page. And so I took a look at it. I was like, oh, it's a sci-fi game? Sure. And it's actually pretty good. It's kind of a mixture of a few genres. As you'll see in a bit, it's got a little bit of a story. It's actually been pretty solid so far as gameplay is concerned. It hasn't crashed or anything like that. It's done in Unity. And I figured I'd take a look at it. I don't know if it'll ever become an actual game, but it's pretty darn cool, I thought. And I figured, why not share the love, and others can go download it and play what's here. So I have a game going on. But I'm going to start a new game so that you can gain, so you get the a little bit of lore that it actually tells you about when you first start up. Plus, you'll be able to see, I'll get into it pretty quickly, you'll be able to see how things flesh out here, because the game I have going is only about a half an hour in as it is. So, starting a new game here. Yeah. All right, so we start out here in this spiral galaxy, and there's a whole bunch of nodes that we could travel to. Now, I thought this started me out before with a tutorial. I guess because I already did the tutorial, it's like you don't have to do it again, which is unfortunate because there was, yeah, no, it didn't start me out in the main area where it's like, here's how everything, here's what's going on in the galaxy and stuff. But basically, that's unfortunate. I guess I would have to reset my, I'd have to delete my save games or something. But basically what's going on is, you're a hotshot pilot. You, the Terran Empire, I guess, or whatever it's called, Terran fleet was utterly decimated by this Scythe Empire, and they're kind of, they've become pacifists in the process of doing that, and this chick wants to gain revenge for all the death and suffering that this Scythe aliens have brought forth. And she, when you do the first mission, you actually save this ship here, the guy that's piloting this ship right here. You save him, and he joins your cause, reluctantly, but otherwise he does join it. And then it's from there you kind of are given this map, and you're said, all right, let's go try and free some other peoples and free some other systems from the clutches of the Scythe Empire. And then along the way, you start to build up your fleet. You get various upgrades and resources, like this one right here will give me two something. Let me see if it says here, two bombers. When I battle this, I'll have two bombers that will join my fleet. I'll get 50 crystals, which are used to do your upgrades and stuff. That's sort of your currency as it goes. And these continue to produce crystals, I think, every battle that you take on. So it's like, it says per battle here and two bombers per battle. It's basically, it'll keep replenishing your bombers and stuff as you go along. And one blueprint, and the blueprints help unlock like missiles and other ships and whatnot. So what we want to do here, we're assisting allied forces. The Centimech is under attack by Imperial forces. A pivotal battle is currently underway in Zasus's orbit. A victory in this battle would rid the system of the Imperial's presence. So let's do that. So now we're going to move out to here, and it's going to zoom me in to where the battlefield is going to be. Now, This is it doesn't really tell you on here. I think this arrow means that's where the enemies are coming from, that direction. I'm not quite sure, honestly, because there's I don't know exactly how you could tell, but basically, once I have a fleet, this is your fleet deployment area. Since it's just me right now in my Valkyrie, I'm just going to deploy myself. And it won't let you begin the battle until you've deployed everybody. You can't leave anybody in reserve, so to speak. So we'll just begin the battle here, and then I'll explain some more of this, like why there's a green circle around me and all that stuff, after we get some fleeties here. So let us... Oh, did I mention that this game is by Chaos Vector? I probably didn't, but oh well. We'll begin the battle. We'll begin the battle. Excuse me. All right, we're flying around. W, A, S, and D to move around and side skirt and everything. Tab to select your target. Our health is in the middle there. Our power's on the left-hand side. And it tells us how much time we have on our power. The heavy fighter is what we've selected, is what we've targeted on the right there. I can hit shift to engage my afterburners. Now you can see my power's going down a bit and how much time I have on them. So get in here to try to get to this guy. And since I have this guy targeted, we'll get a little green box. Yep, like that. That will allow me to lead my target. Ooh, one of our friends got killed. All right, he's down for the count. All right, we got another hostile over here. So you see, it's like a third-person view. He's coming in pretty fast. The circle that you're seeing, the red circle that you're seeing showing up around my cursor there is my overheat. So, oof. That tells me if my guns are overheating. If your guns overheat, you can't fire for a couple seconds. So you do have to manage that. And the guns on this fighter don't overheat too quickly, but on other ones, you might only get like two or three shots before... you start to lose before you have to let them cool down. And there's various different fighters that you get. I had like a healing ship at one point that allowed me to... Like I had guns and stuff on it, but I could also... Ooh, this guy's really hurting me. Hurting me a lot. Oh, get out of there. There we go. And once you destroy all the things... Tower Sunkiller is the name of your... hero. Then you warp back out. And we've got our income source. We got some guided missiles. So that's excellent. We'll be able to use those. You'll see those as we go. And I believe two bombers have joined our cause now. So you'll see those as in our deployment screen. Yeah, we got two bombers here now. And we got the bounty for Zarek, which is plus 50. So we got plus 50 resources coming in. We got new upgrades available in engineering. That's the missiles that we just found. So now we have the blueprint. We have to actually research it. And you see the build cost is 150. We don't have 150 to build it yet. So we can't do that just yet. But it's there for later. So we have that. Now we'll go to the galaxy map. Let's see if we can find something. Now this gets a little flag over it. And it says this system will be reinforced after two battles. I don't know exactly how that comes into play yet. Eventually this flag will turn to an R and it'll be reinforced. And I don't know if that means that I don't have to protect the system anymore, or the system can't be overrun by the enemies anymore, or what that means. I assume it means that, you know, for two turns, this system could be taken over again by the Scythe Empire if I'm not there to help them. I'm not entirely certain exactly what it means, but that too is two battles that I engage in. So if I go to two more of these nodes here, this guy will be fully reinforced. So let's see. This one gives me 82, but that's it, it looks like. This one's a level 3. I don't know if I want to take level 3 on just yet. Maybe we'll stick to the level 1s. This one looks like it has another blueprint available, so we'll go here. Anti-missile corvette. Oh, we'll get an anti-missile corvette out of it too. So sure, we will go and accept. And this will fly us into the battle right away. I'm just using a mouse and keyboard too. I think you can use the control. Well, I don't know if you can use the controller. I haven't actually tried it. Mouse and keyboard works pretty well, so I don't know. I don't know what do you want out of that. So we got two bombers and we got myself. So if I put my ship out there. Now, this green circle is your reinforcement circle. So by putting these bombers inside the green circle, they will essentially fly on my wing. And they will, I can give them rudimentary orders. You cycle through the orders with R, and I'll show you what those are as we begin the battle here. I tend to not like to take too many with me because they do tend to get in the way a bit. So right now we got two in formation, it says over there. If I hit R, I can tell them to hold their position. If I hit R again, I can disband the formation. Or if I hit R again, they will come back into formation. So you can give them some rudimentary orders. Those are the only ones thus far. I'm going to keep them in formation because they will help me take out these bombers. And especially since these bombers are taking out some allies, which is not ideal. And you see my fighter ships just... Wow. Just flew off and destroyed that guy. So that's kind of why I'm like, I would prefer not to have too many things on my wing. Eventually, we'll get interceptors, and the interceptors seem to work a lot better than the bombers on my wing. They don't steal as many kills. damn kill stealers that these bombers are, but you get the idea there. I mean, they are bombers. They're throwing missiles at the enemy, so... Let's see if that did a little bit of damage. There we go. All right, they're down. We got one more hostile target over here. Another bomber. So we'll get all on our way here. Now, the thing to note about the afterburner is it's taking actual energy. So just like the guns will take energy, the missiles take energy. So it behooves you not to use up all of your energy on afterburners, because you do need that for your guns and other things. Now, the guns on this ship don't take too much energy, but on other ships, they take on a lot. The missiles do take a small bit to fire off, and I am limited by how many missiles I could fire. Right now, I don't have any missiles on the ship, so it doesn't matter. Oh, this guy. Well, I'll show that a little bit later. He fired off a missile at me. That was what that red thing was. You have to dodge missiles. You don't have, as far as I know, you don't have like chaff or flares or anything like that. You have to dodge the missiles by literally dodging the missiles. They're not that difficult to dodge, as you'll see eventually, but it's something different than what you might be used to. All right, so we got 150 resources now. We didn't get any resources out of that guy because he didn't give us any, but because we fought another battle, we got 50 from our previous one, which means I can now go in here and I can now research this missile. So now we have guided missiles available on our ship. That's the E means that it's equipped. You can eventually switch what you have equipped and everything. So that is cool. And we have a new vehicle. What is this one? This is the Valkyrie Mark II. Ooh, that's different than what I got last time. Last time I got like a healing ship that was kind of interesting. I was flying around, had turrets, you know, offensive turrets, and had missiles. But it also, as it flies around, it had a turret that would spin around and heal up my allies. So that was kind of an interesting one to have. And then I had something else too. So this is a little bit new, run for me here. It'll cost us 300, so that's going to take a little while before we can do that. But that'll be a good upgrade. As you can see, your armor goes up, energy, hit points, max velocity, all those things. It does have low HP, so you do get sort of a random dice roll along the way where you'll get these extra bonuses / negatives. So in this one has like low HP and good against light vehicles. I think that's what this means. These might be just static for right now. They might be just additional info based on the actual ship. I'm not entirely sure though, but we'll go back here and we'll go back to the galaxy map. And so this one will take two more turns before it will be reinforced. This one needs one more battle before it's reinforced. This one is just some resources. I don't know if we want to go there. This is level 3, which we looks like we can do now. We can take on a level 3. This one has some kind of ship that will give us a ship there. This one's got some blueprints, though. I kind of want to go to this one. Two blueprints, in fact. All right, so destroy hostiles. Now, I assume at some point there might be different mission types, because right now you mostly see destroy hostiles. There might be like a escort or some other kind of thing at some point there. I don't know. I haven't actually gotten far enough into the game to tell you whether or not there's different types. Well, actually, this one looks like a different type over here. Alamorak. It's like a... Yeah, that one's a defensive mission, I think. Where I have to defend the allies. Something like that. So we'll see. Well, as we get in here, we'll see what this does. Very nice graphics and stuff too. I mean, it's pretty well put together. It's for just a short little demo thing here, or proof of concept, whatever you want to call it. It's quite nice. So we've got an anti-missile corvette. So I'm kind of going to put the corvette on its own. And then I'm going to put the bombers with the corvette so I don't have anybody kill stealing on me. Now, I think these guys will go and do their own attack runs. I am not entirely sure how this works when you have multiples like this. I don't know if they just kind of hang around and just wait for stuff to happen, or if they actually actively try to engage. I haven't quite figured that out. I think that they do eventually engage, but I don't know if the enemy go after them or they go after the enemy. I couldn't tell you. I haven't paid enough attention to actually tell you how that works. All right, so we got a bomber up here. You see there's like all kinds of stuff in the background, which is kind of cool. It's very well put together for something that I just randomly stumbled upon. Oh, we have missiles now, so that's that red little circle there. So I can fire that off. That was telling me that I have target lock. Now, if I fire off too early, it may not hit him because he'll have time to dodge it. But I don't know if the AI actually dodges. Oh, and here's the incoming missile that I just had to dodge. So there you see. Wasn't, not particular. Ooh, this guy with this, who's firing on me here? Oh, we're getting wrecked, my friends. We are getting absolutely hammered. Wow. That is actually the first time I've been defeated. That is the first run I've had where I've been defeated. So I don't know actually what happens. Do we start over from the beginning? Pilot reconstruction process complete. All non-reinforced systems are now contested once again. Okay, so that's what that means. Because I never died before, so I didn't know what it meant by reinforcements. So basically, since all the systems were not reinforced, I lost all of them. See, I'm learning stuff here. It was good that I sucked, because now we know something more about the game that I didn't know before. All right, well, I guess we'll just go again. Now this one looks like a different one. Looks like a defensive one. So yeah, assist allied forces. Yeah, so you'd have different types. It's full on, just battle things and then, or attack things, and then other ones where it's like assist forces that are already in the area. So we'll get two bombers and one blueprint out of it. So let's do that. All right, we'll deploy ourselves and get along down. I wonder if my other game is still saved, or if it's been overwritten now, because I think it just does an auto save. Because I don't recall actually. Well, maybe I did actually save that game, because I could try to pop into that game and show you what it looks like when you have different forces at your disposal, because I was actually doing really good in that. I was doing really good in that run. So it's... Alright, there we go. That one's down. And this bomber up here, making short work of these guys. We still have our missiles and stuff, so it's... You don't lose anything from dying other than, as they said, any resources that you would have had coming in every turn because you had... those things. Oh, and here comes the missile coming in. And, yep, missed them. That's how you dodge a missile, my friends. Dodge a wrench, you can dodge a missile. There we go. Alright. Three kills. Three up, three down. And we got Blue Shield Mark 1. Ooh. We can add that to all our other stuff. Although we have no no resources to spend on it yet. Oh, there we go. We got 50 resources now. So what do we get? How much does that take due? Build cost is 100 on that. Okay. All right. Well, that shouldn't take us long to get to there. I would much appreciate some better shields. So we got to stay alive for two battles is basically what that's saying. That's a level 3. We shouldn't take that on yet. Let's take this one on. Because it has a potential to give me more blueprints. I'm all about the blueprints, my friends. Alright, and this time we'll take some bombers as a backup so I don't get my ass handed to me. As I tend to. And some of these capital ships you will actually, like, you can actually fly up to them. I was protecting one freighter, I think, in the tutorial. These I don't know you can fly up to, but there was a freighter in the tutorial that is actually following us now, that's part of our home base, that you actually fly next to and protect from all damages. So is that's a friendly ship over there. All right, good. And where are you at? There you are. There you are. 3 kilometers away. Take some fire, Scarecrow. Alright. What about you? You are 8 kilometers away. So we got a little bit of time here. So you see over on the left there, I've got 3 missiles left and 20 seconds of energy. So we will do. And you see when I fire a missile, it does use some energy. It uses about 5 seconds worth of energy, apparently. Roughly speaking. And there we go. Victory is ours. A very nice looking game too. I can't emphasize it enough that, you know, playing so many early access games that I've played, it's quite a treat to see something like this that's just kind of out there and, you know, it's relatively hidden. All right, so now we can get some of those shields, can't we? So what is this? This one takes 300. Permanent activation and destructible. Finite HP deactivates. Recovery, ship HP recovery. So this shield actually regenerates our ship HP. And this one just does, this one's permanently on. So energy per activation is 35, no cooldown. This one only provides 5 seconds of protection and 40 energy per activation. So this shield will recover his ship hit points and stuff, but it only lasts for 5 seconds. This one is always on, but doesn't recover any of your hit points. So that's interesting stuff there. Nice little trade-offs here. It amazes me to see how much of the little, how many little things there are in this that I wasn't really expecting coming in. So, cool beans. This one's a level 3. I could try that again. This one's just the take them on face to face. Maybe I'll deploy myself differently this time. Maybe I'll actually have helpers instead of deploying them as a separate group. Yeah, we got an anti-missile corvette with us still. Yeah, let's do this. Let us do this. Let's put this here. I'll put the bombers here and here. And I guess I'll have the corvette with us. There we go. All right, begin the battle. Your vehicle is now equipped with a shield. Press space to activate it. This uses significant energy reserves. Excellent. All right, well, this is a permanent shield, so we are going to activate it early on and let the power recover. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do pretty darn good. Suck on hot lead. Oh, and we're overheated. We gotta wait for that to recover a little bit. There we go. Oop, 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 oop. Where are you going? Where are you going? Yo, you're dead? In case you were wondering. How about this guy? Is he closer? Oh, yeah, he's much closer. Much, much closer. I have a missile guy. Ooh, he's firing like flak or something. Jesus. Alright, let's... Yep. Aim on target. The shield is still doing quite nicely. Quite nicely. These guys are flying in with the sun at their backs. A little early missile out there. Test the waters a little bit. Ooh, he's got some kind of missile thing going on there, or some kind of laser going on there, I mean. Alright, and him and this guy. Need to get a life, or get a death, as the case may be. Alright, and... I like how the shield actually gives a clink-clank noise as though it's armor. Which is pretty funny. Oh, and the shield is down, but it's ready. Which is kind of cool. So I can just recharge it right away. Alright. I mean, it takes some energy, but we got some energy to spare. And these interceptors are coming in. Only took 20 hull damage on that. Yeah, I like how the shield doesn't have like an energy sound. It just has like a metal clanking metal sound, which is pretty funny. Let's get some things going there. Nice. Sweet. Do new income source. And we got a paladin. Paladin Mark 1, I think, is the one I was talking about earlier. I think that's the healing ship. And Blue Shield Mark 2. Awesome. Getting all the shields here. And the Blue Shield Mark II is very similar to the one I have, probably, only it's probably a lot more protection. Let's see. Let's go shields. Yeah, it's just 10 more energy per activation, but it's otherwise permanently activated and more hit points. So awesome and sauce and all that. That's 500, though. Can't afford that. A little too rich for my blood right now, but... Vehicles. This guy, Paladin. Yes. Is this the one? Yeah. Heals, allies, protects against missiles. This is the one I was using in an earlier playthrough. It's slow. It's got a low fire rate because it does. You do overheat pretty quickly, but it's got a lot of hit points. And as you fly near your allied ships, you heal them. So it's rather interesting. It's got like a little Paladin cannon on it. That swings around with a green healing beam, healing things. That's 450 though. We are hurting for the cash right now, is what we're hurting for. Let's see if I can get something. So this is all fully reinforced now. So I don't have to worry about losing that if I die again. This one has some good resources, it looks like. This one also has some good resources. You are level 7. I don't even want to try that. Level 6. And 81 there. You've got 82. All right, let's go for the resources, shall we? This is level 5, though. Let's 123, 181. Let's do this one because I'm not ready to. I'm not necessarily ready to take on a level 5 area just yet. Eventually, I will be. I mean, I could probably take it on without any real issues, but yeah. Alright, we got a sniper corvette. Let's put him out here. Let's put an anti-missile corvette next to him so he doesn't have to worry about too many issues. And I'm gonna put my guy out here. And I'm just gonna take one bomber with me. And we shall begin. Alright, there we go. And there's something different in the background. That's neat. Let's just spend a whole lot of time on this. I'm surprised that no one's ever heard of this game. Because really, it looks like someone spent a lot of time on it. It really does. Just all the little stuff. All the little stuff that you can see. Alright. Who else? Ooh, someone else. Someone's got my number. Oh, there, this guy. I don't think so, guy. I have a missile. Alright, let's see if I can do a little of this. Yeah, we'll do a little reverse course. Ooh, I banged right off of him. Okay. Alright, where are we at here? It would be nice if there was like a... if you could target like the nearest of the stuff, but I mean, beggars can't be choosers at this point. There's so much... this game's got so much good stuff going for it that I feel like I can't really complain about anything, because it's just really nice, nicely put together here. Is there another guy that's closer than this guy? No, he's the closest one. All right, so be it. Yeah, looks like our other guys are firing on him, so they're just not in formation with me, which is fine. That's good. They're doing their job, doing their duty. There's my bomber going off to be in formation with it. I see these other lasers going off, which have to be from my Corvettes, I imagine. All right, excellent. Very cool. New income source. We can start to afford some of these swanky upgrades that we've pulled together. Do 301. Excellent. All right, all these things that we are pulling bounties in from. All right, shields. That's 500. Vehicles. You're 450. You are 300. I am now upgrading to the next Valkyrie mark. So there we go. And got these two guys are reinforced now. Excellent. This guy will be reinforced in one battle. This one over here is kind of lonely. I should probably get to him at some point. But we got a level 3 here. It's got two blueprints, it looks like. And this guy's got one blueprint and 96. This one is 181. I wonder, I feel like I should do this one just to get all the resources going, so I don't have to worry about not affording things. So let's do that. And we'll do what we did before. Sniper Corvette with an anti-missile Corvette. And two bombers for you, because I got three bombers now. And then I'll go here, and I'll have a bomber with me. And away we go. Alright, yeah, they're definitely off firing on things. My sniper Corvette is doing his damnedest to snipe at these guys, which is excellent. Let's get our shield up. I keep forgetting I have a shield. Ooh, my weapons. My weapons all sound different now. I got more turrets, I think. Alright, they're also overheating a little bit faster. Ooh, he's freaking taking out my guys. That ain't cool. You're taking out my guys? That ain't cool at all. Take you down. Alright, who is firing on me? These guys are firing on me. Take some hot lead, you bastards. This is a level 5 area, so I wasn't expecting a cakewalk. 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 Who the hell's a cakewalk? Yeah, suck it. This guy on my back. I got a guy on my back. And a load of rice cakes in the cargo hold. We are doing some damage to this guy. He's taking all the hits, though. There we go. Woof. All right. You don't necessarily have to target them to shoot them. You just have to, just harder to aim, that's all. In case you were wondering. Sometimes some of the games you do have to, like, absolutely must target them or else you can't do things, but this is not one of those games. And they're throwing everything in the kitchen sink at me here. Some more Terran interceptors. So you see, as you go up in levels, you do get the challenge does go. Ooh, my sniper Corvette has destroyed. Okay, I was gonna say. All right, he has destroyed a hostile. That's good. I am glad to hear that. Keep juking this guy a little bit. I can get some shots off. Whoa! Wow, he waited till the very end to shoot me with that missile. Just like I waited to shoot that guy till the very end with that missile. Oh, another missile. Okay, this guy. Let's get our shield up. Kabang! Damn straight victory. Damn straight. All right, I'm enjoying the hell out of this. For the little, like, early build that it is, I'm enjoying the crap out of it. I'm really liking this. I like everything about this so far. And there's so many ways that they could go with this too. Ooh, look at all the resources we're getting now. There's so many. Yeah, we gotta pay for some replacement bombers, but you know, we lost a few along the way. Some lives were lost, bringing us the plans to Death Star and all those things. I could do that. I don't really want to pay for that. I would rather have this other blue shield than that one, than the green shield. Not missiles. I haven't found any new missiles, so I'm a little bit unfortunate. And there's a paladin. All right. Let's do one more. Why not? I'm enjoying this so much. I don't want to stop. I'm enjoying it so much. All right. We will do this one that has the two blueprints. Let's do that. Even though it's level 3. It's beneath me, but I still want to see. I want to get those blueprints. I must collect the blueprints. Oh, we got two sniper Corvettes now. Well now, let's put one there, we'll put one there. We'll get an anti-missile Corvette on this guy. We'll put two bombers on this guy. And then I will be in the center with a bomber escort. Well, I can't, no, I should be there, right? Is there not, I can't have an escort now? Oh, that's weird. I guess you're limited to two. So I guess that bomber's just going to kind of sit there. Yeah, there's nobody on my wing, yeah. Oh, I didn't know that. I didn't know you were limited to two. It might have told me that in the tutorial. By the way, this does have little tutorial text that pop up. You didn't see it because I already went through it. But it does have little tutorial texts and things when you first start, so you don't have to worry about not knowing how to do things. Let's get out of the way of that missile. Go, this guy. This guy, though. Oh, I forgot to put my shield up. What is wrong with me? What is wrong with me? Oh, and my shield's back down again. All right, let's go this guy, and oh, nope. Die, guy, die. Down and spin us around. Bam! And a little bit of this. A little bit of this. As you're taking on shots from my other guys. Oof, he's getting pounded. Absolutely pounded. Oh my god, he's threw two missiles at me. There we go. Oh, the anti-missile Corvette. Doing its namesake. Alright. Bombers destroyed hostile interceptor. Man, my guys are They're not taking any prisoners today. We got a heavy fighter, Ibra Or, heavy fighter coming in. Try to hit this guy. All right, let's go like this. Oh, we're overloaded. Or yeah, over. we're overcharged. Whatever it is. Overheated. That's the word. That's the word I was looking for. Over something. We're over something. Okay, we got guided torpedo, and a devastator. Ooh. Now, let's see what these look like as far as stats go. We lost a bomber, but otherwise, not too shabby. So new upgrades, missiles. Guided torpedo Mark One has 75 more hit point damage, less shots per second, more energy uses per shot, larger explosion radius, less range, a whole lot of less range. And very bad turn rate. Okay. So then, what do we have for the vehicles? Devastator Mark One, 500 hit points, one armor, 75 energy, less than what I've got. Max velocity is very slow. Hit points regenerate per second, zero. Energy regenerate per second is very low. But it's got 150 millimeter Devastator on it, so it could do... Okay, so it's a long-range sniper, basically, with a huge gun on the front. So if you wanted to do play the long game there. We got the Paladin there, which is kind of cool. Let's look at our shields again. Let's get our upgraded shield, shall we? That sounds like a great idea. All right, and... Yeah, unfortunately, I'm going to have to end the episode at some point here. I'm going to have to end this video at some point. This has been... let me see if I can get back to the main menu here. Yeah, there's no save. It does an auto-save, so my other previous save will be gone. Overloaded, overwritten with that. But that's fine. We pulled that one out of the jaws of defeat, I'd say. So, my friends, that has been Heroes of Andromeda. It is by Chaos Vector. Or CK Cornflake or Cadacious, depending on which service you're looking at. It's just a demo game, a development build. It is free. You can download it for free on itch.io. I will leave links to that down in the description. I'll also leave links to its Steam early concept page. There's not much you can do on the early concept page. I don't think you can vote for it, but it's there if you want to take a look at it there as well. Like I said, it doesn't look like it's had been terribly active. Its last development was about 300 days ago, or 2015, it sounds like. But it's still a fun little game that's free. You can go download it, take a look at it, enjoy what's there. There's a lot to like as to what's there already. It's a genre bender, so it's certainly very interesting from multiple perspectives. So. There you have it, my friends. Thanks so much for watching, everybody, and I will see you next time.